Welcome everybody once again. So we are in module 3. This is our 9th class for module 3. In the previous classes we saw about the derivation of Bernoulli's equation from Euler's equation, the problems related to that. Then we saw what is a Venturi meter, orifice meter, Pitot tube and orifices. Then we saw some problems related to Venturi meter. And in the last class, we saw some problems related to orifice meter and pitot tube. So today, we are going to see some problems on orifices. So the first problem is orifice, you know, it is a part of a tank. It is an opening in the tank, right? In order to discharge the water. That is called, this opening is called orifice. Okay. Now, we will move on to the problems. The first problem is the head of water over an orifice of diameter 4 cm is 10 meter. Okay. So, we have a tank. We can assume that. Let us assume that we have a tank and we have an orifice. The diameter of this orifice is 4 cm. So the diameter of the orifice is 4 cm and the head of the water over the orifice. So from the center line of the orifice, the head of water, so water will can be up to this level, right? So, from the center line of the orifice, the head of the water is H, is taken as 10 meter. Find the actual discharge. So, what is Q actual? And actual velocity. What is actual velocity of the jet at Vena contractor? Take CD is equal to 0.6. And CV is given as 0.98. CD means coefficient of discharge. Nothing but actual discharge by theoretical discharge. Coefficient of velocity is equal to actual velocity by theoretical velocity. So now, we need to find the actual discharge and actual velocity of the jet at Vena contractor. So we know what is Vena contractor. See, when the water is flowing out from this, you will have a diameter, a smaller diameter of the jet. This portion is called a Vena contractor. So, how will we determine the actual discharge and actual velocity? Now, we know the area of the orifice. See, we know the diameter of the orifice is 4 cm. Therefore, so 4 cm is 0.04 meter. So, diameter of the orifice is 0.4 cm, that is equal to 0.04 meter. So, from this we can get the area of the orifice as pi d square by 4. This d is diameter of the orifice. So, we get pi into 0.4 square divided by 4. We get area of the orifice as 0.001256 meter square. Now, CD is given as 0.6 and CV is given as 0.98. We can find the theoretical velocity. We know theoretical velocity is by using the formula. So, theoretical velocity is equal to, we know for an orifice, the theoretical velocity is square root of 2gh. So, it is square root of 2 into g is 9.81 meter square per second. Meter per second square. and h is 10 meter, right? So it is 10. Everything is in meter. So we get the theoretical velocity as 14 meter per second. So if the theoretical velocity is 14 meter per second, what is the theoretical discharge? Theoretical discharge is equal to theoretical velocity into area of the orifice. So we get theoretical discharge as 14 multiplied by 0.001256. We get it as 0.01758 meter cube per second. So what is actual discharge? So from this we can find the actual discharge and actual velocity, right? So actual velocity is equal to coefficient of velocity into theoretical velocity. So we get actual velocity is equal to coefficient of velocity is 0.98 multiplied by theoretical velocity is 14. So we get 13.72 meter per second actual velocity, and actual discharge, Q actual, actual discharge is equal to coefficient of discharge into theoretical discharge. So coefficient of discharge is given as 0.6. Theoretical discharge we have determined it as 0.01758 meter cube per second. So actual discharge is 0.01054 meter cube per second. So this is your answer. You are asked to find actual discharge and actual velocity. So actual discharge and actual velocity. Now we will move on to our second problem. So our second problem is, okay, a jet of water issuing from a sharp edged vertical orifice under a constant head of 10 centimeter at a certain point has the horizontal and vertical coordinates measured from the vena contracta as 20 centimeter and 10.5 centimeter respectively. Find the value of CV, also find the value of CC if CD is equal to 0.60. See, now a jet of water issuing from a sharp edged vertical orifice under a constant head of 10 centimeter. So constant head is given as 10 centimeter. So how can we draw the diagram? We may have a tank. Okay, you can have an orifice here. So it is a sharp edged vertical orifice under a constant head of 10 centimeter. So this distance, you may have, this may be the free surface of water. So this distance is 10 centimeter. That is our capital H. Head, H is equal to 10 centimeter. Constant head of 10 centimeter at a certain point has the horizontal and vertical coordinates measured from the vena contracta. That means, see, your water is flowing like this. And at one particular point, you will have a smaller diameter, and that is called vena contracta. And here at this vena contracta, you have the x coordinate and y coordinate. So the x and y coordinate are given as, so h is given as 10 centimeter, that is nothing but 0.1 meter. The x coordinate, x is given as 20 centimeter, that is equal to 0.2 meter. And y ordinate is given as 10.5 centimeter, that is nothing but 0.105 meter. We need to find the coefficient of velocity, coefficient of contraction. Also CD, coefficient of discharge, is given as 0.60. C, See, now since we have the ordinates x and y at the vena contracta, we can use the formula which we have determined using the experimental determination. Experimental, we have studied experimental determination of hydraulic coefficients. So there we saw the hydraulic coefficient Cv, that is the hydraulic coefficient of velocity Cv is equal to x by square root of 4yh. So x is given as 20 centimeter. So you can have it either in centimeter or in meter. Okay, so we shall take it in meter. So 0.1, sorry, x is 0.2 divided by square root of 4 into y is 0.105 into h is 0.1. So we get Cv equal to 0.976. Now, we have obtained Cv. We need to find what is Cc. We know coefficient of discharge, Cd is equal to coefficient of velocity into coefficient of contraction. From this, coefficient of contraction is equal to coefficient of discharge by coefficient of velocity. Coefficient of discharge is given as 0.60. So coefficient of velocity, we have found it as 0.976. So we get coefficient of contraction Cc is equal to 0.615. Okay, now we will move on to our third problem. Our third problem is the head of water over an orifice of diameter 10 centimeter is 10 meter. Okay, so we will draw a tank with an orifice. Okay, now it is given the head of water over an orifice of diameter 10 centimeter is 10 meter. So the diameter of the orifice is 10 centimeter. The head of the water is 10 meter. So here the diameter of the orifice is 10 centimeter. And if this is the free surface of water, the head of the water h is equal to 10 meter. Okay, now the water is coming out from an orifice is collected in a circular tank of diameter 1.5 meter. So your water is coming out like this. So this water is collected in a circular tank of diameter 1.5 meter. So it is collected in a circular tank. So the diameter of this tank is 1.5 meter. The rise of water level in this tank is 1 meter in 25 seconds. So our h is given as 10 meter. Diameter of the orifice is 10 centimeter, that is 0.1 meter. The diameter of the collecting tank, you have a collecting tank. So in this collecting tank, the diameter is equal to 1.5 meter and the water collected is the rise of water level in this tank. Rise in water level, you can take it as a small h, is 1 meter in 25 seconds. That is, in this collecting tank, the rise of the water level is 1 meter in 25 seconds. Also, the coordinates at a point on the jet measured from vena contracta are 4.3 meter horizontal and 0.5 meter vertical. So in the vena contracta, we have X and Y. So X is given as 4.3 meter and Y is given as 0.5 meter. We need to find the coefficients. What is coefficient of discharge? What is coefficient of velocity? And what is coefficient of contraction? Now, we know how to find the coefficient of velocity. Right? So the coefficient of velocity, Cv is equal to x by square root of 4yh. So x is given as 4.3 meter divided by square root of 4 into y is given as 0.5 meter and h is given as 10 meter. So we get the coefficient of velocity as 0.96. Now we need to find coefficient of discharge as well as coefficient of contraction. So now we will find the coefficient of discharge first. So for finding the coefficient of discharge, we need to find the actual discharge and the theoretical discharge. Okay. Now, we will find, in order to find the theoretical discharge, we will find theoretical velocity. So we know theoretical discharge is equal to theoretical velocity into area of the orifice, right? Into area of the orifice. So we know that the formula for theoretical velocity is root of 2gh into area of the orifices, pi into diameter of the orifice square divided by 4. So we get our theoretical discharge as square root of 2 into 9.81 into h as 10 meter. Into pi into diameter square, that is 0.1 square diameter of the orifice divided by 4, we get the theoretical discharge as 0.1099 meter cube per second. This is the theoretical discharge. Now we can find the actual discharge. See, actual discharge is area of the collecting tank into velocity in the collecting tank. Right? That will be, what is the water collected here? That will be our actual discharge. So our actual discharge will be equal to area of collecting tank multiplied by velocity in the collecting tank. So what is the area in the collecting tank? We know area in the collecting tank is pi into diameter of the collecting tank is 1.5 square. So 1.5 square divided by 4. Multiplied by the velocity. What is velocity? Distance by time. So here the distance is the height of the water collected. That is 1 meter. So 1 divided by time is 25 seconds. 25 seconds. So we get our actual discharge as 0.07068 meter cube per second. Now, our coefficient of discharge Cd is equal to theoretical discharge by actual discharge, which we get the theoretical discharge is 0.1099 divided by actual discharge is 0.07068. So we get Cd is equal to 0.643. Now we need to find one more hydraulic coefficient, that is the CC. So we know CD is equal to CC into CV. Coefficient of discharge is equal to coefficient of contraction into coefficient of velocity. So substitute the values, we get CC is equal to 0.669. That's all. So now we will move on to our fourth problem. Okay, our fourth problem is a 25 mm diameter nozzle discharges 0.76 meter cube of water per minute. So you have a nozzle, right? So we will draw the nozzle first. So this is the nozzle. So this, the diameter of this nozzle is 25 mm diameter, right? This nozzle, this diameter is 25 mm. That is 0.025 meter. It discharges 0.76 meter cube of water per minute. So the discharge, we will write the diameter of the nozzle is given as 25 mm. That is nothing but 0.025 meter. Now the discharge, that is the actual discharge. This discharge is the actual discharge. So Q actual is equal to 0.76 meter cube per minute. So convert it into second, you get 0.76 divided by minutes to second multiply by 60. Okay. So we get 0.01267 meter cube per second. Now, when the head is 60 meter, so capital H is given as 60 meter. The diameter of the jet is 22.5 mm. That means, so this can be taken as small d. That is nothing but the area of the orifice, diameter of the orifice. So small d is taken as 22.5 mm. That is equal to 0.0225 meter. Now we need to determine what is CC, what is CV, what is coefficient of discharge. Now also we need to find the loss of head due to fluid resistance. We need to find HL. So these things, these much things we need to find. So how are we going to find? See, if this is a nozzle. Okay, now. We know CC is coefficient of contraction, right? We have already studied in our previous classes. Coefficient of contraction is equal to area of jet divided by area of the nozzle. So what is area of the jet? So this is diameter of the jet and this is diameter of nozzle. So the area of the jet is pi into d square by 4, that is 0.0225 square divided by 4 by area of the nozzle is pi into 0.025 square divided by 4. So we get, see, we can cancel pi pi, you can cancel 4 4. So you get 0.0225 square divided by 0.025 square, we get 0.81. So CC is over. Now, we will try to find what is CD, coefficient of discharge. We know coefficient of discharge is equal to actual discharge. So actual discharge by theoretical discharge. So what is the actual discharge? Actual discharge is given as 0.01267 meter cube per second. By theoretical discharge is nothing but theoretical velocity into area of the orifice. Here instead of orifice we have nozzle. So what we get is 0.01267 divided by the theoretical velocity is root of 2gh multiplied by area of the nozzle. Area of the nozzle is pi d square divided by 4. So we get 0.01267 divided by square root of 2 into g is 9.81, h is 60 meter multiplied by pi into d square. D is 0.025 square divided by 4. So from this we get the coefficient of discharge Cd is equal to 0.752. Now we will try to find coefficient of velocity. So we know coefficient of discharge is equal to coefficient of velocity into coefficient of contraction. So from this, coefficient of velocity is equal to coefficient of discharge by coefficient of contraction. So that is equal to coefficient of discharge is 0.752 divided by coefficient of contraction is 0.81. So from this we get coefficient of velocity is equal to 0.928. Now we have to find about what is the losses. So how will we find the losses? In order to find the losses, we have to apply Bernoulli's equation at the outlet of the nozzle and the jet of water. Okay, so outlet of the nozzle and the jet of water. So at nozzle, at the outlet of the nozzle and the jet of water. Nozzle we will take it as 1 and the jet of water we will take it as 2. So now we will apply the Bernoulli's equation. So Bernoulli's equation, we will take 1 at the nozzle, at the outlet of the nozzle, and 2 at the jet. So we know the Bernoulli's equation is P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2 plus losses. Now, see, at the outlet and at the jet, these both are in the atmosphere. So they are the atmospheric pressure head. So P1 by rho g is the atmospheric pressure head. P2 by rho g is the atmospheric pressure head. So pressure head at 1 is equal to pressure head at 2. Okay, that is P1 by rho g is equal to P2 by rho g because that is atmospheric pressure head. Now, see, this nozzle is in the horizontal. So when you are taking the center line, Z1 will be equal to Z2. There is no difference in the center line. Therefore, Z1 is equal to Z2. So, and we know V1, see, since P1 by rho g is equal to P2 by rho g, we can cancel these things. Since Z1 is equal to Z2, we can cancel this. So HL is equal to 1 by 2g into V1 square minus V2 square. Now, this V1 is equal to square root of 2gh. that is nothing but the theoretical velocity. Okay, V1 is root of 2gh, V2 is the actual velocity of jet, that is Cv into root of 2gh. See, at V1, that the reason is, at 1 there is no losses. When it comes from 1 to 2, there will be some losses. Okay, so because our section is from 1 to 2, we are considering the section from 1 to 2. So, between 1 to 2, there will be losses. So, here V1 is the theoretical velocity, V2 is the actual velocity by considering the losses. So, what we get is, HL is equal to 1 by 2G into V1 square minus V2 square. So that is equal to 1 by 2 into 9.81 is equal to V1 square is multiplied by V1 square. That is 2 into 9.81 into head. How much is the head here? H is 60 meter. So 60 minus V2 square is Cv square. So Cv square is 0.928 square into 2gh into V1 square is 2gh minus Cv square into 2gh. So we get 1 by 2 into 9.81 into, you can take this 2g out, 2gh out. So you get 2 into 9.81 into h is 60 multiplied by 1 minus Cv square is 0.928 square. So we get the losses HL is equal to 8.328 meter. Now we will move on to our next problem, the fifth problem. So fifth problem is, a tank has two identical orifices in one of its vertical sides. Okay, so you have a tank, and in this tank you have two identical orifices. Here you have orifice 1, you can have orifice 1 and orifice 2. Okay, you have two orifices, orifice 1 and orifice 2. In one of its vertical sides, the upper orifice is 3 meter below the water surface. So if this is our water surface, this one is 3 meter below the water surface, and lower one is 5 meter below the water surface. If the value of Cv for each orifice is, so Cv is given as 0.96, find the point of intersection of the two jet. So that means from here the water is flowing down, from here also the water is flowing. So at one point both these jet meets. So you need to find this point of intersection of the jet. Okay, so see, this x is the experimental determination, this is our x, and for y, from 1 to this is y1, and from this from 2 to this. This is our Y2. We can write this as Y2. Okay. Now we need to find what is X, Y1 and Y2. So how will we determine that? So this is our H1, this is our H2. Now, let us take this point of intersection be P. So let P is equal to point of intersection of the two jets. Okay. P is the point of intersection of the two jets. So we know X is the horizontal distance of P. Y1 is the vertical distance of P from the orifice Y1 and orifice 1, and Y2 is the vertical distance of the intersection, the point P from the orifice 2. Now, what is this Y1 now? See, this Y1 is equal to this Y2 plus 5. Okay. So Y1 is equal to, see, this distance Y1 is equal to Y2 plus this distance. That is Y2. This is Y2 plus this distance. How much is this distance? 5 minus 3. So Y2 plus 5 minus 3. So we get Y1 is equal to Y2 plus 2 meter. Now, for orifice 1. Okay. So, for the first two orifice, the coefficient of velocity CV1 is given as x by square root of 4y1 h1. H1 is 3 meter and h2 is 5 meter. So, that is equal to x by square root of 4y1 into 3 meter. H1 is 3 meter. Similarly, for the orifice 2, we get CV2 is equal to x by square root of 4y2h2. So we get x by square root of 4y2 into h2 is 5. Now it is given in the problem, CV for each orifice is 0.96. That means CV is equal to CV1 is equal to CV2. So we will equate CV1 and CV2. We know CV1 is equal to CV2. So from this, x by square root of 4y1 into 3 is equal to x by square root of 4y2 into 5. From which we get 3y1 is equal to 5y2. So now we have two equations, right? So from this we get y1 is equal to 5 by 3 of y2. See, we have this equation. We will take this as equation number 1 and this as equation number 2. So equating these both equations, equation 1 and 2, we get, so 1 is equal to 2. So equating 1 is equal to 2, we get y2 is equal to 3 meter. So if y2 is equal to 3 meter, y1 is equal to y2 plus 3, y1 is equal to 5 meter. y1 is equal to y2 plus 2, so y1 is equal to 5 meter. Okay, Now we will take any of the equation, that is, we will take CV1 is equal to x by square root of 4y1h1, which is equal to, which implies we know CV1 and CV2 is equal to 0.96. 0.96 is equal to x by square root of 4 into y1. y1 is 5 into h1. h1 is 3 meter. So from this we get x is equal to 7.436 meter. So we have found the ordinate, that is x comma y1 is equal to 7.436 comma 5, and the ordinate x comma y2 is equal to 7.436 comma 3. This is your answer. Okay, now we will move on to our last problem. No, not last problem. Sixth problem. So our sixth problem is a closed vessel. A closed vessel contains water up to a height of 1.5 meter, and over the water surface there is air having pressure 7.848 Newton per centimeter square. That means, in order to convert into kilogram force per centimeter square, you divide it by 9.81, you get 0.8 kilogram force per centimeter square above the atmospheric pressure. At the bottom of the vessel, there is an orifice of diameter 10 centimeter. Find the rate of flow of water from the orifice. Take CD is equal to 0.6. Okay, so a closed vessel. You have a closed vessel. This closed vessel consists of a water up to a height of 1.5 meter. So, for a height of 1.5 meter, we have water. And over the water surface, there is air having pressure. So, above this, there is air. Up to this, there is water. Above this, there is air having pressure of 7.848 Newton per centimeter square. At the bottom of the vessel, there is an orifice. So, you have an orifice at the bottom. Of diameter 10 centimeter. Find the rate of water, rate of flow of water from orifice. Take CD is equal to 0.6. Okay. So, see, the diameter of the orifice is 10 centimeter, that is equal to 0.1 meter. Now, CD is given as 0.6 meter. So, from the orifice, the height of the head, H is equal to 1.5 meter. So, the air pressure is given as, P is given as 7.848 Newton per centimeter square, that is equal to 7.848 into 10 to the power of 4 Newton per meter square. Now we will apply the Bernoulli's equation at 1 and 2. So we will take the section 1 at the free surface of water and section 2 at the orifice. We will apply the Bernoulli's equation. So, applying Bernoulli's equation, we know P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2. Here there is no information about the losses. So, we will take losses as 0. We will consider there is no losses. Now, see Z1 is 1.5 meter above Z2. So, Z1 is equal to 1.5 meter, Z2 is equal to 0. This we will take as the datum. So Z2 is 0, Z1 is 1.5 meter. Now, this P2 by rho g. See, P1 by rho g is atmospheric pressure. It is a 7.848 into 10 raised to 4 Newton per meter square is the intensity. So this is nothing but P1 by rho g. So P1 by rho g is equal to 7.848 into 10 to the power of 4 divided by density 1000 into 9.81, that is equal to 8 meter of water. So P2 by rho g is the atmospheric pressure, so this will be equal to 0. P2 by rho g is equal to 0. Okay. See, this is above the atmospheric pressure. It is given above atmospheric pressure. So here it is the atmospheric pressure that is equal to 0. So P2 by rho g is equal to 0. Now we will substitute the values in equation number 1. That is Bernoulli's equation. We get 8 plus okay, V1 square by 2G. And this V1 is negligible because we will maintain constant head. Constant head is maintained. So V1 is negligible, approximately equal to 0. So V1 square by 2G is equal to 0. Z1 is 1.5 meter. P2 by rho G is 0. V2 square by 2G. Here we have the velocity. Velocity is more. Here we have more velocity. It cannot be negligible. Plus Z2 is 0. So from this, we get V2 is equal to 13.652 meter per second. Actually, what we need to find the rate of flow of water from the orifice. We need to find what is the discharge. So the rate of flow, we know discharge is equal to CD into theoretical velocity. Here it is V2 multiplied by area of the orifice. That is area at section 2, area of the orifice. So we get CD is given as 0.6 multiplied by velocity is 13.652 multiplied by area of the orifice is pi by 4 into the diameter is 0.1 square. So we get the discharge as 0.0643 meter cube per second. Now the last problem. See, last problem is a practice problem for you. This problem is similar to the previous problem, similar to the sixth problem. I will give you the answer. The answer is, here you need to see, here the discharge is given. Discharge is given, you need to find the pressure. You need to find what is P1. You need to find the pressure intensity P1. So apply Bernoulli's equation and find P1. You will get your P1, the value as 9.125 newton per centimeter square. This is your problem for practice. Okay. So with this, we will stop today. The remaining problems we will see in the next class. That is, we have problems on orifices with a large rectangular orifice, fully submerged orifice, partially submerged orifice, and the time required for emptying the tank through an orifice. So these much problems we have. So these problems we will see in the next class. Thank you.